We get to breaking news this morning. Knoxville Center Mall is closing after a decade of decline.
Developing tonight, 10 on Your Side has learned the 42-year-old Greenbrier Mall is just the latest in our region headed towards foreclosure.
Now JCPenney is on its way out.
Sears may have just hours to survive.
There will be just three Kmart stores left in the U.S. after the Avenel, New Jersey store closes its doors tomorrow.
When's the last time you went to a mall? An enclosed mall, not an outdoor mall, an indoor mall. Was it crowded, busy, or was it empty? Void of any customers or stores, a shell of its former past.
Hi, I'm Scooter. Malls were a large part of my childhood, as they are to most Americans. When I got older, I became fascinated with the ever-growing visual of decaying retail stores and abandoned malls. It's easy to pull over and take a picture or two, but I want to dig deeper and see what happened to the American shopping mall. Last week, I went to my childhood mall. There I am, age 6, in a rocket, in front of the Sears. And there it is today. No toys, no rocket, and no Sears. A once bustling mall on opening day in 1997 turned to an empty shell of its former past in 2022. What led to the downfall of the modern shopping mall? To answer this question, we need to take a deeper look at its history. Before there were malls, there were standalone department stores. Most of the department stores that we know today that we see in malls, like Sears and JCPenney, began as catalogs. Sears started as a catalog in 1893, and they sold clothes, sewing machines, jewelries, cars, and even houses through that catalog. They still sold catalogs all throughout the 1900s when they opened stores, and all the way until 1993. Sears built their first brick-and-mortar store in 1925. They only had standalone stores and catalogs until malls popped up in the 1950s. One of the first modern malls as we see them today is the Valley Fair Mall in Appleton, Wisconsin. Unfortunately, this mall closed in 2006 and became a shopping center.
This is the once thriving Valley Fair Mall. Built in 1954, it's one of the earliest self-contained group of stores, a prototype of what we know as a mall. Now its empty parking lot stands in a vast snowy steppe, windswept and abandoned. These are the ruins that we will leave behind. Perhaps the mall is dreaming of Christmas seasons past, when its entrances still beckoned with welcome and warmth to the shopper.
Malls were a huge part of what American culture was in the 1960s, 70s, and 80s. They were a symbol of capitalism, of economics, of a working class. People had their first jobs, first dates, first going out with friends without parents around, in malls. They provided entertainment, shopping, food, and more, all in one building.
Pretty far out.
And why do you think that?
Because it's like where the cool people
Movies were filmed in malls, singers would tour and go to malls, and music videos were filmed in malls.
To Amazon.com. Amazon.com.
But malls got the biggest slap in the face in the 1990s and 2000s when technology was ever growing.
I feel like everything is gearing more towards strip malls. Everybody is in such a hurry. They want to be able to park, go into the store they want, and out in the shortest amount of time.
Ohio has an extremely heavy concentration of malls, but mostly dead and abandoned malls. In our own college city of Tiffin, Ohio, there stands an abandoned mall.
On the west side of town, the Tiffin Mall and the Westgate Shopping Center also offer...
The Tiffin Mall, home to Planet Fitness, the Mexican restaurant, and an abandoned JCPenney's.
Night after night, we would congregate pretty much in front of our stores and be able to just stand there and talk and like look down either way, and there's not a human in sight. It was when it was like, okay, this is definitely not going to last. Most people, rather than even waste their time going in, would go to Finley that had everything that we had and then some. And then whatever they didn't like purchase-wise that they got in Finley or Sandusky, it was much more convenient to take it into Tiffin to return it.
All the doors to the mall are locked. It's an abandoned mall. The most notorious dead mall in all of America is right here in Ohio. Rolling Acres opened in Akron, Ohio in 1975. With 4 anchor stores, plenty of tenants, a food court, a movie theater, and more. Everything a mall would need. In 2008, the mall closed, and it became... The mall closed in 2008, but stood abandoned for 10 years. The mall became notorious for the ruin and decay that was brought upon the mall. Broken glass and fixtures, mold and stagnant water, and even animals roam free in the dilapidated ruins. It wasn't until 2019 when it was finally announced that Amazon will build a distribution center where the mall once stood. The very thing that killed malls is now taking over their property.
The lights went out in parts of Summit County this afternoon, but it was not your typical power problem.
A man was electrocuted, apparently trying to steal copper cable from the Rolling Acres Mall.
Not only did the ever-growing access and convenience of technology hurt shopping malls, but high crime rates had a major role in the decline as well.
The breaking news, stay at home, that is the order.
And just when it couldn't get any worse, in 2020, COVID-19 hit the world hard. And because of this, malls closed, companies declared bankruptcy, and people stayed at home for work, for school, and for shopping. So, what happens next? The pandemic still continues every day, and there doesn't seem to be an end. Will malls survive? Most likely not. Once a symbol for American culture, once a root of nostalgia for us all, and once a hub of human activity, gone in a few decades. Our days of riding that food court merry-go-round and sneaking to the back of Spencer's with friends are numbered.